Hello class, I welcome you all to this session. This session we are going to learn about GST. So in the chapter journal we have journal entries including the concept of GST. So first you need to understand what is GST. GST is nothing but goods and services tax. Now this tax is levied on supply of goods and supply of services. It is an indirect tax charged. Now indirect tax in sense there is no relationship with income level of persons, that is the assessees. There is no relationship. If you are consuming some goods, if you are consuming, in sense you are purchasing some goods, then you are supposed to pay GST. If you are getting some services, say for example, you are going to a beauty parlor, you are having a good haircut, hair styling, and you are coming back, on which GST will be charged. This is not related with your income. Even though you do not have any income, or if you have crores and crores of income, the tax percentage that's going to be charged is same. It is an indirect tax charged. That's why it is indirectly related. Okay, indirectly related to the income level. So it is indirect tax charged each time supply is made. So whenever supply is made, supply can be goods or services. It can be services also. So when goods are sold, when services are sold, then there is a charge of GST. Now again you have to understand that all the goods need not attract GST. There are some exempted goods. There are some nil rated goods where your percentage of tax is zero. So we are not talking about those kind of goods. We are talking about only those goods which attracts GST. Either 12% or 18% or 5%, whatever it is. So it is charged only by a registered taxpayer. Now this is very important. Those who are registered under the GST law, that is they are having the GSTN, they only can charge this tax amount. Now what are the categories of GST? You have CGST, which is nothing but central goods and services tax. SGST, state goods and services tax. UTGST, union territory goods and services tax. IGST, integrated goods and services tax. Now when, see, these are all the components of GST, various categories of GST. So when this CGST and SGST are attracted is when there is intra-state supply. Suppose for example there is a supply from Salem to Chennai. Say for example this supply is 100 laptops. Okay, so 100 laptops, there is a supply from Salem to Chennai. Now this is within the state, am I right? Salem is within Tamil Nadu, Chennai is also within Tamil Nadu. So when there is within the state, then it is called as intrastate. So if it is within state, what gets attracted? CGST gets attracted and 18 GS, I mean SGST get attracted. Now the rate of GST for this transaction can be 18%. This 18%, how it will be charged? It will be charged as 9% CGST, 9% SGST. So this is the basis of charge. So 9% of tax will go to the central government and 9% of tax will go to the state government. Now, instead of supply within state, if it is a supply within union territory, then it would attract UTGST. Say for example, Delhi. So for within Delhi, there is a supply. One location of Delhi to another location of Delhi, there is a supply. Then what will get attracted? CGST and UTGST will get attracted. Now if it is involved a union territory, say for example Puducherry, then it is a union territory. So when this is there, then CGST, it will not state as a state GST. You will not say that it is a state. It is a union territory. That's why it is UTGST. Similarly, IGST. What do you mean by IGST? It is integrated goods and service tax. It is when it is attracted when there is interstate. When there is interstate transaction, it is outside the state. That is Tamil Nadu to Kerala. It is outside state. Tamil Nadu to Kerala. Say for example, from the state of Tamil Nadu to the state of Kerala, there are 100 tons coconut is being supplied. Okay, so maybe coconut oil we can see. So or liters, okay, supply. In this case, it is a between state. Tamil Nadu is one state. Kerala is another state. There is a supply from one state to another state. Then what gets attracted? IGST gets attracted. Okay. Or suppose there is an import. Import from USA to India. There is an import from USA to India. In this case also IGST will get attracted along with customs. Okay. So this is the basis of how you have to categorize the GST. So you should be able to identify whether it is intrastate or interstate. Intrastate means it is within the state. Okay. Interstate means it is between or outside the state. From one state supply goes to the other state. Here it is within state. Okay. Now there is something called as input GST and output GST. Now what is input GST? GST paid by the purchaser of goods or services is input GST. It is paid by purchaser. When I am a registered person, I am purchasing some goods. I am purchasing, say for example, I am purchasing 100, say for example, number of mobile phones. The tax is 18%. Okay, so when I am purchasing this 100, 18%, okay, so this will be my input GST. This 18% goes to my input as a input GST. This is my input. Now, I have purchased this cell phones to actually sell this cell phones to some other person. If I am selling, if I am purchasing, then it is called as input because it's an input to me. Okay, so input GST. When I am selling, I have to pay to the government. So, it is called as output GST. Okay, so when there is input GST, when you are purchasing any goods, then if you are a registered person, you would call that as input GST, or GST collected by the seller of goods or services is an output. Seller of goods or services is an output GST. If you understand this logic, or if you're not able to understand this, for now you remember purchaser of goods input, seller of goods or services output. So you remember this alone, we will be able to understand with an illustrative example. So this is just one example that I have given you. A registered person under GST law, he is having the GSTN. If he has purchased 100 mobile phones, 18% GST. This 18% GST will be a input GST. Once he is selling the goods to the customer, then he would collect GST from the customer. This GST he has to pay to the government. Okay, so that's why it is called as output GST. So the next point is GST is charged on the net value of goods and or services supplied at the prescribed rate of GST. Now what is this? Is charged on the net value. Now net value is after your trade discount. Okay, this is after your trade discount, it is called as net value. So GST is charged on the net value of goods or services supplied at a prescribed rate of GST after trade discount. Now there is a tax invoice here, you can see here, I guess there is a tax invoice. I hope that you are able to see now. Okay, now look into this. There is a tax invoice here. So in this tax invoice, you have the list price to be 20,000, trade discount 2,000, sale value 18,000, under that CGST 6% 1,080 and SGST 6% 1,080. So invoice price becomes 20,160. So what is this GST? GST is charged on the sale value. This is the net value after trade discount. Keep that in mind. You know what is trade discount, right? So if you look into this, the journal entry for that transaction would be debtor's account debit to sales account. Debtors have to pay how much? 20,160 together with the GST, and to sales account 18,000. To output GST, whenever you are selling goods, there will be output CGST and output SGST, because you need to pay this amount to the government. Okay, so this is what it means. So I hope that this video is clear and you are able to understand the basics of GST right now. I will see you in the next video. To recap, what is trade discount? It is normally allowed by the seller to the purchaser who further sells goods to the customer. So that is called as trade discount. We are not talking about the cash discount here. So cash discount, we are not talking about that. So purchaser sells to the customer. We are not talking about cash discount. We are talking about only the trade discount in GST. So when, what, at what scenario GST will be charged? It will be charged at the net value after deducting the trade discount. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing. Thank you, class.